Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech. An iOS 16 public beta and iOS 16 beta 3 re-release have been out for a couple of weeks, and there's even more new features and changes I wanted to share with you that have been found since the initial What's New video or follow-up videos. Also, iOS 15.6 has been out for a few days, and there's a couple of features and changes that I wanted to talk about there. And of course, we're all waiting for iOS 16 public beta 2 and iOS 16 beta 4 to release to developers. We'll talk more about when to expect that a little bit later in the video. But first, let's talk about the App Store. Earlier this week, I talked about how Apple Arcade will have some games that are leaving, and Apple has actually clarified what happens if maybe you're using one of these games and then they remove it from the App Store. So there's a bunch of games here. It looks like it's a whole category now that may change over the future. And if they remove them, Apple released a support document as to what's happening if a game is leaving Apple Arcade. So as you can see, it says games might sometimes leave Apple Arcade. If you download a game before it leaves Arcade, you can play the game for at least 2 weeks after. If you try to launch an arcade game that is no longer playable, you receive a no longer available message. After a game leaves Arcade, the game developer might choose to make their game available on the App Store. These games might vary from the arcade version. If the developer makes their game available on the App Store and allows you to load your saved progress, you can pick up where you left off in the arcade version. So it clarifies that as well as some other things here, and hopefully not too many games leave, but at least you'll be able to pick up where you left off in most cases if the developer allows it. I'll link this in the description below. Now there's a new feature in settings that I wasn't able to show before, and I've mentioned in early beta videos, but if we go into general, and then we go down to language and region, under language and region, if we change the language to maybe French, so we'll slide up here, switch it to French, hit continue, give it just a moment, it'll change the language. Now once it's changed, we have a new category. This is available for languages that have a masculine and feminine option, but now you'll have non-specified and neutral as well. So you'll see this for things such as Spanish and French and maybe English eventually. So you have some other options here, but you can see that there's a new category. This isn't available under English, so I didn't see it before, but finally it's here for those that have been wanting that. Otherwise, it will be showing up later, probably in English and more. So hopefully we'll see that soon if that's something that you wanted to change. So you'll see here that it doesn't show up under English. Now, if you go into your settings here and go down to accessibility, there's a new feature for accessibility users under Siri. Under Siri, you can see here, we have a Siri pause time. This is super helpful if you need a little bit more time to respond. Default is just what you've always had, and then you have longer and longest. So if you need a little bit more time to respond, whether that be you're just having trouble speaking, or just in general, you speak slower and need to respond a little bit differently, it will now allow that. So that's great that they have that option. Now, if we go down into Safari, within Safari, we're back at that support document I showed earlier, you can now pin these documents so they show up in your tabs later on. So if we press and hold on the address itself, we can pin that tab. So if I pin it, go to our different tabs here, you'll see it's pinned and it's very easy to access without going into your bookmarks. So something I often go to is Apple security updates. You'll see the recent security updates for Safari and iOS 15.6. I want to pin that. Again, I can pin it. You can unpin it the exact same way, just press and hold. So we'll do that again, and you can unpin the tab if you want to. Also, one quick thing I actually discovered by accident that has been here for a very long time and I just really didn't notice, or maybe I talked about it in a video a long time ago, is if you press and hold on the AA, which turns on Reader and flips to dark mode. Something I just noticed when I was playing around with this. So instead of going into settings, just hold it and it will flip to Reader. Super convenient feature on Safari. Now also, if we go into the fitness app, or previously the activity app, within the activity app, if you tap on your account in the upper right, usually indicated by your picture, toward the top, we have health details, change goals, and unit of measure. If we go into change goals, we can now change our goals directly in the fitness app instead of having to go to our Apple Watch where we had to before. This is super convenient now that we can actually use the iPhone and the fitness app without having an Apple Watch. We can change our calorie goal and more, our move goal and more throughout the day. So probably should change this, but this is what it's set at for now, and you can change it directly here instead of your watch now. Now, if we switch over to iOS 15.6 that I have on my iPhone 13 Pro, there was a big thing in the news this week about AirTags and them not showing up in Find My with their battery status. So if we go into Find My, so within AirTags, you'll see I have five of them. Some of them are blurred, but you'll see toward the bottom, there actually is a battery status saying that it's low. it won't show a battery unless it's actually low. This was changed in the code, and thanks to my friend Steve Mosier for helping me out with that, but it was actually changed in the code quite some time ago, and it just won't show unless the battery is low. They're not showing an actual status. Maybe that has to do with battery savings on the AirTag. Maybe not, but hopefully they bring that back. Also in iOS 15.6, if we go into settings, go to notifications, scroll all the way to the bottom, we have test alerts. Test alerts was added in some of the earlier betas. I mentioned them in the beta videos, but forgot to mention it in the iOS 15.6 video. Apple didn't mention it specifically, but now depending on your region, you'll have a test alerts option as well if you want to hear those. If you don't, just leave it off. Now with iOS 16 public beta 2, there's a few features I hope that we see that we know about, but we haven't seen really active yet, or that they removed. Apple removed the feature in Siri where you can actually hang up using your voice. It was there in previous betas. It's not here now. Hopefully they bring that back with beta 4 and public beta 2. Also, we still haven't been able to track orders in Apple Pay. So if we go into our wallet, at the top of the wallet, we have orders. Now I ordered my MacBook Air using this, using Apple Wallet, and it didn't show up. So that programming or code isn't complete yet. Hopefully we see that active in beta 4, but that's what I'm hoping for with that update. Now, as far as bugs and issues in iOS 16 public beta, some of the bugs I've mentioned before are still there. Of course, it'll take an update to fix that. If we go into our name at the top within settings and under iCloud, if we go into passwords and keychains, you can see there's a word that's misspelled. It says securely instead of securely store your passwords. So I would expect them to fix this in a future update. There's going to be bugs here and there. And of course, if you're having issues, whether it be something that's spelling or not, make sure you report it in the feedback app, as Apple needs to categorize those, see what's wrong, and then resolve those issues. Now, I've heard from a lot of you that apps are still crashing, whether that be Instagram or TikTok. I've seen TikTok crash. I've seen Instagram crash. Usually with TikTok, if you're sharing something, that will crash, and some apps don't work at all, certain banking apps and more. So those are sometimes problematic and can be a problem. Voice dictation continues to be an issue, as well as iMessage group conversations for me, where the reply box just goes away and then comes back. Sometimes it's there, sometimes it's not. For example, on my 13 Pro Max, it's there. On the iPad, it's not. On my computer, it's there. On macOS Ventura, but on the iPhone, it's there. On the iPad, it's not. And then sometimes it'll just switch around. So that's definitely still an issue. Setting your wallpaper can sometimes be an issue. That was an issue on the iPhone 8 Plus a little bit earlier. I set this wallpaper and it just went to a black screen. So it looks fine now. I had to go back in a couple times, go in and customize it, and then it worked. But prior to this, trying it a couple times, it would just be completely black. So it would be nothing on the background at all, whether that be the lock screen or home screen. Also, music is still randomly stopping for some people, which can be problematic, of course, but it is a beta, and the phone is getting still too warm for some people. I've heard quite a few reports that it's just very hot for some people with the current beta. So that has to do with processing in the background. The phone will monitor the overall temperature and keep it within range, but it still can be a problem. Additionally, things such as voiceover and live captions can be a problem. So if you're using voiceover full time, you need to use that in your settings. So under accessibility, if you're using voiceover full time, you may want to hold off to make sure it works properly, maybe with beta 2 for the public beta or beta 4 for developers. If not, and you don't use it, it's fine. But otherwise, just beware that it could be problematic. Also, iOS 15.6 seems to be quite good for most people. Very stable, very few issues I'm hearing from most people, with the exception of one thing, and that's CarPlay. CarPlay continues to be an issue for some people. So some people are saying CarPlay is problematic. Again, for me, it's not too much of an issue, as I don't use CarPlay too much. However, in the comments, there was only one person saying that they had an issue with CarPlay. So I'm curious what type of car that is, whether it be Honda, Toyota, Mercedes, BMW. I'm curious what vehicles are having this issue, as it may not be every make or model. Now, overall battery life for most people is quite good on iOS 15.6. It's been out a few days. It's been more than enough time to stabilize, and thanks to Cameron for sending this in. And you'll see on a 13 Pro Max, he's getting about 7 hours and 52 minutes of screen on time and 2 hours and 5 minutes of screen off time. And that's using about 60% of his battery. Pretty good battery life there. Today, he had 6 hours and 15 minutes and 9 hours and 39 minutes of screen off time. And again, used about 60% of his battery. So 12 to 14 hours of screen on time is right where you should be. That's great. And you can see his most used app was Messages. As far as iOS 16 battery life, that's a little bit different. For me, it hasn't been great. I've been going to bed at night sometimes with it very low. We're at 60 or 59% now. Let's go into settings. We'll go into battery. And you can see my battery health on this device is still 100%. Again, here's my cycle count based off coconut battery. And if we go back to the last 10 days, yesterday I used over 90% of my battery, or maybe 80% of my battery, and only had 4 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours of screen off time. Today, you'll see 3 hours and 15 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 22 minutes of screen off time, and 15% used mail, even though I wasn't in it. And again, this is a beta, and that's one of the problems with betas, is sometimes they just use a lot of power. The same is true mostly on iPadOS. So on iPadOS, you'll see here, I've been using it on my 12.9-inch iPad Pro. We'll go down to battery. Again, here is my cycle count from coconut battery. And if we take a look at yesterday, I used 1 hour and 54 minutes of screen on time, 52 minutes of screen off time, and used only a quarter of the battery. That's actually pretty good, but today it was last charged at 9:34 a.m. I've used it 2 hours and 15 minutes, although for some reason, recently deleted apps is using a ton of power, and we're down to 88%. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not, but I definitely find that I charge it just about every single day and don't use it a whole lot. So usually about 5 or 6 hours of screen on time. However, based off this, it would suggest I'd get 10 or so, or 8 to 10, but I'm really not seeing that. So I think this is off a little bit, and you can see the icon for recently deleted apps is missing as well. Also, performance on the iPad is quite good. I really haven't had too many issues. Mail is occasionally buggy for me, but performance-wise, it's fine. It's nice and smooth with ProMotion, and typically, other than what I mentioned already, hasn't been a problem on iPad. Most of the things are problematic on iPhone. Performance-wise is quite good as well, whether that be the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus, which is the oldest device. I can't believe I'm saying that, as it doesn't seem that old to me. It's one of my favorite phones. The last one with the home button that was a large phone, and so it seems pretty good performance-wise, whether you're scrolling through different apps, going through different menus and more, it seems to be just fine. As far as when to expect iOS 16 Public Beta 2 and iOS 16 Developer Beta 4, that should be sometime this week. Based on what they did last year, that seems to make the most sense. Typically what we have every year is the public beta releases alongside a re-release, and then 2 weeks later or so, we have the next release. Last year with iOS 15, they released the public beta on June 30th, along with Beta 2 re-release, and then on July 14th, they released Public Beta 2 and Beta 3. So that's typically what they do, and then the public betas will be the same day or the next day. It just varies from year to year, so we can expect probably on Tuesday or Wednesday we get the public beta. We also could get iOS 15.7 betas. So typically we could have that, maybe to fix that issue with the AirTag, or we could just have an iOS 15.6.1, or both. 15.6.1 or 15.7. Of course, all of that will go until the end of August, maybe early September, where we have that release to the public, and then we switch over to iOS 16. So typically in mid-September with iPhone 14, 14 Plus, 14 Pro, and 14 Pro Max. That's usually what we're expecting, although again, that could change, but that's what I would expect this time around. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and some of your comments. So if we go into YouTube, you can see here at the time of this video, there's 8.9K votes. So 8,900 votes from this morning, 9 hours ago, thanks to everyone that voted, and 143 comments. I've read all of those comments. We'll read a few in just a moment, but you'll see 58% are using 15.6 currently. That's a huge amount that have updated. 34% are on the public beta or beta 3. Only 2% are on 14.8 or older, 1% 13.7 or older, and 6% are using Android. Typically, every week or so, there's actually more using Android. So it looks like 8% last time. Of course, we still have a bunch to vote yet, but let's go ahead and take a look at a few of your comments. Let's take a look at some of the comments. I just chose a few randomly. Stevie3100 says, running iOS 15.6 on my 12 Pro Max, battery life has been good and no issues with performance or connectivity issues with Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. 15.6 runs better than 15.5 to me. Jared Cardona says, I'm using iOS 15.6 on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. It has been running smoothly for me and battery life has been really good. Heshan Ramandala says, iOS 16 Public Beta 1 is quite stable. Really enjoying the new lock screen and all the new features. Some glitches and lagginess here and there. Animations are not as smooth as before, but as a beta, it's really improving. Only major issue is the battery life. My average screen on time shortened by 2 hours. All the banking apps work for me, or are working for me. Boris Berber says, using 15.6 on iPhone 13, and it's been pretty great so far. Performance is still amazing, and the battery life seems a bit better compared to the previous versions. No complaint here. Ty Amidi says, updated to 15.6, and CarPlay is now not working in both cars. Removing the car from CarPlay doesn't work. Wish I hadn't updated. And this is where I mentioned earlier, I'd love to know what car that is, and just to see if it's common, although I've only seen this one comment about it. Ash KB says, iPhone 11, iOS 6, 16 public beta. Apart from a few banking apps, the rest is all good. A few bugs here and there, nothing major. Just Dave says, hi Aaron, I've been using iOS 16 beta 3 on my 13 Pro Max. For me, it's had more bugs than beta 2. The music app continues to crash, as well as third-party apps not seen previously, such as Instagram and YouTube. Just as with iOS 15 betas, the automations within shortcuts do not run. Battery life is not any better for me. Hopefully we see a significant improvement with the next beta. Although my banking app is now working in beta 3. Keep up the great work you do. And thank you. So that's everything with iOS 15.6, public beta 1, and beta 3 re-release. Of course, we're all waiting for those next updates, and hopefully we see those very early next week. If you found anything else I haven't mentioned in other videos, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.